Welcome to e-learning course on Applied Thermodynamics, Module 1, Air Standard Cycles and IC Engine, Session 12, IC Engine. Myself, Ramesh B.R., Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Jain Institute of Technology, Davangere. The basic task in the design and development of internal combustion engines is to reduce the cost of production and improve the efficiency and power output. In order to achieve the above task, the engineer has to compare the engine developed by him with other engines in terms of its output and efficiency. Hence, he has to test the engine and make measurements of relevant parameters that reflect the performance of the engine. In general, the nature and number of tests to be carried out depends on a large number of factors. During this session, only certain basic as well as important measurements are tested and described in relation to internal combustion engines. Further, we define what is mean by an internal combustion engine. An internal combustion engine is a heat engine in which the chemical energy of fuels is converted to thermal energy and in turn is converted into mechanical energy, which is used for various types of mechanical transmissions such as industrial works, transportation systems and small power generation systems. In all internal combustion engines, the heat energy is developed by the combustion of fuels inside a closed chamber called engine cylinder. Next, we see some of the classifications of internal combustion engines. Here we will discuss a broad classification of internal combustion engines. The first classification is based on nature of fuel used in the engine. The second is method of ignition of the fuel in the engine cylinder. The third is cycle of operation. The fourth one is arrangement of the engine cylinder. The fifth one is method of cooling system used for the engine cylinder. Sixth one is use of engines. And the last one is speed of the engines. So, these are the seven broad classifications what we can have for internal combustion engines. Now, we see one by one. The first one, nature of fuel used in the engine. So, based on the type of fuel used, we can have petrol, diesel and gas engines. These are the three types of engines which are available based on the type of fuel. Next is method of ignition. If the engine works on spark ignition system, we will call it as spark ignition engine. If the engine works on compression system, we will call it as compression ignition engines. And these are the two classifications we have based on method of ignition of the fuel inside the cylinder. Next is the third one, cycle of operation. We have two types of operations. One is two-stroke cycle engine and another one is four-stroke cycle engine. So, nowadays we are also have five-stroke as well as six-stroke cycle engines. If the cycle of operation is completed in two movements of the piston, we will call it as two-stroke. If the cycle of operation is completed in the four movements of the piston, we will call it as 4-stroke engine. Next is based on arrangement of the engine cylinder. It is based on the orientation of the engine cylinder. The first one is horizontal engine. If the cylinder is in the x axis, we will call it as horizontal, or if it is in the horizontal plane, we will call it as horizontal engine. If it is in the vertical direction, we will call it in vertical engine. So if the cylinders or pistons placed in a radial directions, we will call it as radial engine. If the pistons are placed one after the other in a line, so we will call it as inline engine. If the piston is placed, or the engine cylinder is placed in V shape, we will call it as V engines. And the last one is opposite piston and opposite cylinder type. Here the pistons or cylinders will be kept in the opposite direction. And next classification is method of cooling system used. Two types of there: air cooled engines and water cooled engines. If air is used, we will call it as air cooled engines. If water is used for cooling purpose, we will call it as water cooled engines. The next classification is use of engines. So these are the few engines what we have. So first one is automotive engines. If an engine is used in automotive purpose or for any transportation purpose, we will call it as automotive engines. Or in specific, we can say that if an engine is used in automobiles, we will call it as automotive engines. If an engine is a stationary one, we will call it as a stationary engine. So this engine will not be moved from one point to another point. It will be kept stationary at a point or in a place. Marine engines. So these are the engines which are used in marine applications like ships, boats, etc. Locomotive engines. So these are the engines which are used in locomotives like railways. And the last one is aero engines. So these are the engines which are used in aerospace like rockets, aeroplanes, air jets, etc. And the last classification is speed of the engines. So we have total three speeds: low speed, high speed and medium speed. So based on the speed, we are going to have these three classifications. So moving further, we have combustion in SI engine. So SI engine means here it is a spark ignition engine. So now we are going to discuss how the combustion takes place in a spark ignition engine. So generally, combustion may be roughly divided into two types. One is normal, another one is abnormal. Normal can also be called as knock free. Abnormal is also called as knocking type of combustion. Here we make a use of pressure versus crank angle diagram to describe how combustion in SI engine going to take place. So moving further, so A to B, you can observe in this diagram, A, this is a point A and this is a point B. So A to B is a compression process, and B to C, see point number B here and C is here. So B to C is combustion process in SI engine, and point C to D on this curve represents an expansion process. Okay, so generally a spark ignition engine will have different strokes. Either it may be a 4-stroke or a 2-stroke. Compression takes place, combustion takes place, expansion takes place. So all these processes remain same. Only the difference is that the construction of the engine. So according to Ricardo, who is known as father of engine research, have identified three stages. One is ignition lag stage, that is represented here with 1. The second stage was flame propagation stage, which is represented by 2 in the diagram. And the point number 3 is after burning stage, which is represented as 3 here till point D. Okay, so these are the three stages which has been identified by the Ricardo. Now we see one by one what are these stages. So what will happen in the engine during combustion process? Ignition lag stage. There is a certain time interval between instant of spark and instant where there is a noticeable rise in pressure due to combustion. So you can notice from point A to B there is a rise in pressure. So it is a noticeable rise in pressure, and point A, so this is a point where instant of spark takes place, and we can observe a noticeable rise in pressure from point A to point B. This time lag, so whatever the time lag from point A to B, is called ignition lag. It is called as ignition lag. Ignition lag is a time interval in the process of chemical reaction during which molecules get heated up to self-ignition temperature, gets ignited and produces a self-propagating nucleus flame. All these things will take place during the ignition lag. The ignition lag is generally expressed in terms of crank angle. In this case, you can take it as theta 1. The period of ignition lag is shown by the path A and B. This path is ignition lag path. Ignition lag is very small and lies between 0.00152 to 0.0002 seconds. An ignition lag of 0.002 second corresponds to 35 degree crank rotation when the engine is running at 3000 rpm. This is the observation what we can make. Angle of advance increases with speed. So angle of advance means here crank angle for ignition lag. So angle of advance increases with speed. As you increase the speed, ignition lag will also increases. This is a chemical process depending upon nature of fuel, temperature and pressure, proportions of exhaust gas and rate of oxidation or burning. So ignition lag depends on nature of fuel, temperature, pressure, proportion of exhaust gas present inside the cylinder and rate of oxidation or burning. The second stage is flame propagation stage. Once the flame is formed at point B, you just observe the diagram. Once the flame is formed at point B, it should be self-sustained and must be able to propagate through the mixture. There will be a mixture present in the cylinder and the flame should be propagated through the mixture. This is possible when the rate of heat generation by burning is greater than heat lost by flame to surroundings. After the point B, the flame propagation is abnormal at the beginning as heat lost is more than heat generated. Therefore, pressure rise is also slow as mass of mixture burned is small. Therefore, it is necessary to provide an angle of 30 to 35 degree if the peak pressure to be attained is 5 to 10 degrees after TDC. After TDC, here it is TDC, after TDC. The time required for crank to rotate through an angle theta 2 is known as combustion period, during which propagation of flame takes place. And the last stage is after burning stage. Combustion will not stop at point C but continues after attaining peak pressure, and this combustion is known as after burning. This is generally happens when the mixture is supplied to the engine is a rich mixture, and this is how a combustion going to takes place in spark ignition engine. Next we move on to combustion in compression ignition engine. Generally here also we have two forms of combustion, normal and abnormal, as of in the spark plug engine. So we make a use of pressure and crank angle diagram. The combustion in SI engine starts at one point and generated flame at the point of ignition propagates through the mixture of for burning of the mixture, whereas in a CI engine the combustion takes place at a number of points simultaneously and a number of flames generated are also many. To burn the liquid fuel is more difficult, it is to be evaporated. It is to be elevated to ignition temperature and then burn. So when you compare this with SI engine, there we are going to burn mixture, but here we are not going to burn the mixture, we are going to create mixture inside the cylinder. After that only we are going to ignite the mixture inside the cylinder. So this is a major difference of combustion in SI and CI engine. So based on that, the combustion engines, that is the combustion in CI engines, is considered to be taking place in four phases as compared to three stages in SI engines. The first stage is ignition delay period or pre-flame combustion. The second stage is uncontrolled combustion. The third stage is controlled combustion, and the fourth stage is after burning. So you can identify all the four stages in the diagram. So this represents, the first two dotted line represents ignition delay period, the second two dotted line represents the uncontrolled combustion, then it represents controlled, and after that it represents after burning process. Now we see the different stages of combustion one by one. The first one is ignition delay period of pre-flame combustion. The fuel does not ignite immediately upon injection into the combustion chamber. In diesel engines or in compression ignition engines, normally fuel is spread through the injector into the cylinder. So immediately after injection the fuel will not catch fire. So here the fuel does not ignite immediately on injection, so there is a definite period of inactivity between the time of injection and actual burning. So this period is known as ignition delay period. So there will be an inactivity between the time of injection and actual burning of fuel. So that whatever that period of gap is called as ignition delay period. In figure, the delay period is shown on pressure crank angle diagram between point A and B. So this is a point A, start of injection, and this is a point B, start of combustion. So there is a delay from start of injection to start of combustion. The ignition delay period can be divided into two parts, the physical delay and the chemical delay. So whatever this ignition delay is there, it can be divided into two parts. The first one is physical delay and the second one is chemical delay. The delay period in CI engine exerts a very great influence on both engine design and performance. It is of extreme importance because of its effect on both the combustion rate and knocking, and also its influence on engine starting ability and the presence of smoke in the exhaust. So now we see the second
one, second stage, uncontrolled combustion. The period of rapid combustion, also called the uncontrolled combustion, is that phase of combustion chamber in which the pressure rises rapid. You can see here, there is a rapid pressure rise after start of combustion till this point. So during this process, we are going to get, or we are going to attain maximum pressure in the combustion process. During the delay period, a considerable amount of fuel is accumulated in the combustion chamber. These accumulated fuel drops burn very rapidly, causing a steep rise in pressure. You can observe in your diagram. The period of rapid combustion is counted from end of delay period or the beginning of combustion to the point of maximum pressure on the indicator diagram. So the uncontrolled combustion process stops at this point. This is a point of stop when it reaches maximum pressure. The rate of heat release is maximum during this period. This is also known as uncontrolled combustion phase because it is difficult to control the amount of burning or injection during the process of burning. It may be noted that the pressure reached during the period of rapid combustion will depend on the duration of the delay period. The longer the delay, the more rapid and higher is the pressure rise, since more fuel would have been present in the cylinder before the rate of burning comes under control. And then third stage is period of controlled combustion. It starts from this point and ends at this point, ends here. The rapid combustion period is followed by third stage, the controlled combustion. The temperature and pressure in the second stage are so high that fuel droplets injected burn almost as they enter and find the necessary oxygen, and any further pressure rise can be controlled by injection rate. The period of controlled combustion is assumed to end at maximum cycle temperature. So wherever the maximum cycle temperature is going to attain, so at that point of period, we can conclude that the stage 3 ends. The last stage is period of after burning. So combustion does not stop with the completion of injection process. The unburnt and partially burnt fuel particles left in the combustion chamber start burning as soon as they come in contact with the oxygen. This process continues for a duration of 70 to 80% of expansion stroke. This process continues and ends at 80% of the crank angle. And this is how a combustion is going to take place in compression ignition engines. Further, we move on to detonation and factors affecting detonation. So first we discuss what is meant by a detonation or knocking. So knocking is due to auto ignition of end portion of unburned charge in combustion chamber. As the normal flame proceeds across the chamber, pressure and temperature of unburned charge increase due to compression by burned portion of the charge. This unburned compressed charge may auto ignite under certain temperature condition and release the energy at very rapid rate compared to normal combustion process in cylinder. This rapid release of energy during auto ignition causes a high pressure differential in combustion chamber, and a high pressure wave is released from auto ignition region. The motion of high pressure compression waves inside the cylinder causes vibration of engine parts and pinging noise, and it is known as knocking or detonation. This pressure frequency or vibration frequency in SI engine can be up to 5000 cycles per second. Detonation is undesirable as it affects the engine performance and life, as it abruptly increases sudden large amount of heat energy. It also put a limit on compression ratio at which engine can be operated, which directly affects the engine efficiency and output. By referring to the figure, we are going to define the phenomenon of knock. The phenomena using the figure A and B, which shows the cross section of the combustion chamber, this figure A and figure B, as well as figure C as well as D, is going to show the cross section of the combustion chamber with flame. So these are the flames advancing from the spark plug location, a without knock, whereas figure C shows the combustion process with knock. So there is a difference between these two figures, you can observe. So these are the waves because of spark provided to the mixture, which is traveling from point A to point B. And here you can notice a small change here. So the figure A represents without knock, and figure C represents with knock. In normal combustion, the flame travels across the combustion chamber from A towards D. The advancing flame front compresses the end. You can observe here there is a compression of charge. So the advancing flame front compresses the end charge, that is B, B dash and D, thus rising its temperature. The temperature is also increased due to heat transfer from the hot advancing flame front and due to pre-flame oxidation. In spite of these factors, if the end of charge temperature had not reached its self-ignition temperature, the charge would not auto-ignite and flame will advance further and consume the charge B, B dash and D. This is the normal combustion process, and the same thing can be seen on your pressure and crank angle diagram. So compression is taking place, ignition starts at this point, and there is no knock here because there is no upfront flame wave coming backward from D to A. So there is no disturbance in the generation of flame here. However, if the end of the charge B, B dash and D reaches its auto ignition, if this charge reaches its auto ignition temperature and remains for some length of time, the charge will auto ignite, leading to knocking in combustion. So it is assumed that when flame has reached the position B, B dash, the charge ahead of it has reached critical auto ignition temperature, this part, double ashed part. During the pre-flame reaction, if the flame front would move from BB dash to only CC dash, then the charge ahead of CC would auto ignite and travel in the opposite direction. Because of auto ignition, another flame front will be generated for CC dash and D, and starts to travel in opposite direction to the main flame, which is coming from A towards D. When the two flames collide, a severe pressure pulse is generated, which is known as knocking or detonation. And this can be observed in your pressure and crank angle diagram. There is a compression process. Once the ignition starts, so the pressure starts to rise and there is a disturbance in the flame front wave because of the flame which is coming in the opposite direction. There is a variations in the pressure pulses because of collision of flame taking place at C, C dash and D. Next we move on to factors which are affecting the detonation. When any one of the following factor is applied during an engine's combustion cycle, the likelihood of detonation is increased. So the following factors will affect the detonation in large numbers. So we see one by one. Increased compression ratio results in increased pressure. As you increase compression ratio of a engine, so increase in pressure takes place. As the increase in pressure takes place, so there will be a chances of increase in detonation. The next factor is improved volumetric efficiency. As you increase the volumetric efficiency of an engine, we can see substantial increase in pressure. As a result, we can notice chances of increase in detonation. The third factor is leaner mixture. If you use a leaner mixture during a combustion process, there will be a chances of increased combustion temperature. As a result, we can see chances of increase in detonation. Increased ambient air temperature increases the engine temperature. As the incoming air temperature is more, so the overall temperature of the engine will also increases. As it increases, the increase in detonation will be there. Increased bore diameter, increased time. As you go on increase the bore diameter, the time required for combustion also increases. So for that, greater distance of combustion path takes place, there may be chances of increasing detonation. Increased ignition advance. If you increase the ignition advance, if you are going to reduce the delay in ignition, the delay period, if you reduce the delay period, so there may be increased time for combustion. So you will get large amount of time for combustion process. So as it happens, so there may be a chances of increase in detonation. Decreased speed, which increases time for combustion. So if you decrease the speed, the time required for combustion increases. As the time required for combustion increases, so there may be chances of increase in detonation. So these are the factors which is going to affect detonation in large cases. And this is the end of session on introduction to the IC engines and combustion of SI and CI engines and factors affecting detonation. Thank you very much. Please do subscribe to my channel BR Mech Academy.